Round one saw the championship's first ever Estonian event winner, Sim Plangi, picked up the yellow jersey on the Sunseeker as well. 18-year-old Ocean Price won the Fiesta Sport Trophy this year on his way to today's confrontation. Jukka Korhonen blitzed the establishment with a one-off championship visit and second place on the Pirelli. Tommy Doyle produced an outstanding drive to collect his yellow jersey and be part of a home 1-2 on the Irish tarmac. Citroën Racing Trophy champion Desi Henry also joins the shootout. Peter Taylor's season finally came together on the Yorkshire gravel, beaten to the flag only by Marty McCormack's title-winning drive. The car they compete in today is the car the winner will drive next year, an R2 Skoda Fabia 1600 with almost 190 horsepower and a 5-speed sequential box. And Skoda have done this sort of thing before, of course. And first, the judges need to sort out six very competitive packages, and that calls for people who really do know what they're looking at.
I'm looking at somebody that can obviously represent rallying in general, and somebody that really, really needs the price. You know, somebody that's really, really hungry. From the driving perspective, obviously the approach, the initial, what they were doing with the car, the feeling of the car, and also their lines and their smoothness, and of course, you know, how they applied themselves to the whole couple of days.
I mean, these guys are all young. I mean, I think the youngest is 18-year-old, and I mean, they're doing a fantastic job out there and in front of the camera as well.
The level has been extremely high. Nobody's done really any major errors, and they've all got to hold their heads very, very high tonight.
It's just a pity that, you know, there's only going to be one winner.
And it was the mysterious and very fast Finn, Jukka Korhonen, who pipped his rivals to win that drive for next year.
Now, Jukka, this season, you're going to be driving this Skoda. Tell us how that's going.
Yeah, I'm really waiting to start the season, and what I see, new Skoda, Fabia R2, and I'm really waiting. It looks very great, and I'm very happy.
You've been given this amazing prize by Pirelli, so it must be a way to just concentrate on doing some of the driving this season.
That is a great opportunity for me, and it's like a little factory seat for me, and I get the good support in Pirelli and the export, and it looks very great.
Luckily, he drives faster than he speaks English, because he's up against some tough competition in cars that start off higher on the spec sheet, like Callum Black Suzuki, which Justin Dale enjoyed so much earlier on.
So, Callum, looking forward to 2012?
Yeah, it's going to be a big year for me. I think the BRC is going to be very competitive in the front-wheel drive. I think it's the right way to go, and in my opinion, if you can drive a front-wheel drive quick, you can drive any car quick, so it should be quite a competitive championship.
Hoping to make sure it is, AVS are running two cars, including a Fiesta for Geoffrey Jones.
Well, I think it's fantastic going back to Formula 2, going back to front-wheel drive cars, which I grew up on as well. Much better chance for the younger guys to get going in the series.
And what about the AVS team? What can we expect from a two-car team this year?
Well, with myself and Matt, we've got a good blend of experience and youth there, and I think, you know, we've got a good chance to try and do well in the team award, I think, compared to everybody else.
Autosport Technology won that title last year after dominating round one. But the fight for the driver's crown went elsewhere, and on the Bulldog we saw the first of two titanic clashes between Mark Donnelly and Martin McCormack. That gave them one win apiece on gravel. And then on tarmac for the first time at the Jim Clark, Donnelly had a super special nightmare.
Jesus.
He wrecked his rear suspension and his title chances as McCormack took a dominant win. this was Ulster. And he's got the hazards on, leader by 13 seconds. McCormack was unstoppable, taking a historic overall win to go with his two-wheel drive victory. All he needed to do in Yorkshire was finish, and he almost didn't. But he got away with that and capped his season with the Formula 2 title. And just look at the battle for second and third places.
The British Rally Championship is going to take in all corners of the British Isles. That's England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland.
It's England first. The Sunseeker is on gravel in the New Forest, just outside Poole. They call this gravel as well, but it's the thick, heavy mud of the Welsh forests, and it's a completely different challenge. Then it's the Pirelli, some of the hardest and fastest stages of the year. Think the tarmac would be easy after all that, but this is the Jim Clark Rally and it's never easy. Scenic and beautiful, the winding lanes of Northern Ireland's Causeway Coast are like Monte Carlo without the money and the yachts or the ice. And it ends on the gravel stages of North Yorkshire, British Rallying's longest day. Cronin, he's wide there, he's sideways, it's all over the place. And yes, he's back. Just once on the Sunseeker Rally, one of the most exciting and exhilarating drivers of recent years, Keith Cronin, in the official Twingo, will be a sight to behold.
So that's it. That's what the 2012 British Rally Championship looks like, and it looks like it's going to be a cracker. Everyone here is really excited about it, and so are we. We hope you join us, which will be the first round, the Sunseeker Rally in Bournemouth. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.